The string of numbers right here hides a way to access your personal information, location, and can even pave the road for full-scale cyber attacks against you. Therefore, knowing how to change IP address is actually pretty critical these days. I'm going to cover three pressing questions here. What is IP address? Why do you need to change it? And finally, how to change IP address successfully. If you need a specific answer right away, you can look at the timestamps below. Let's start with explaining the IP address, meaning behind it, and what it looks like. This is your digital address online, which appears as a set of four numbers. Each of them can go from 0 to 225, with a few exceptions, such as IP addresses reserved by big companies. Anyway, that's how IP addresses normally look. This address is assigned to you by your internet service provider and is used to establish the connection from your device to the world web. This also means if you go to the office, you already have a different IP address, and the same goes for your mobile phone. If you're curious about how to check IP address of your device, there are websites online that answer this question pretty easily. That information also serves as a good answer to the question, why should I change my IP address? Well, if a random website online can see it, who else can see it? And who else can get this information about you? Ultimately, your IP address can be used to pinpoint your approximate location, track your activity online, find your email address, social media, and so on, to the point where it can leave you open to threats such as denial of service attacks, which disrupt internet connection, or even threat actors accessing your devices and their content. Such threat actors could acquire your personal data and sell it or use it against you. Furthermore, some websites build user profiles based on your IP address, and such profiles not only let them show you personalized ads, but also create a risk of such profiles getting into the wrong hands. In some cases, the consequences of exposing your IP address could evolve into personal data security issues. By getting access to your IP address, threat actors can scan ports for vulnerabilities and access your devices with personal information. And furthermore, this information could then be used to execute spear phishing campaigns against you or even commit identity theft. As I've mentioned before, hackers can try your connection to your home, potentially getting access to all the devices in your network, including all your mobile devices, computers, even smart home devices if you have them. The more devices you or your family possess, the greater the risk. One more reason to hide my IP lies in online restrictions. It's not that big of a deal usually, but a lot of websites limit access to users from different countries or from specific regions. Since your IP address is a reason a website can even tell where you're from in the first place, changing it can trick that website into believing that you should have access to that content. This goes for entertainment content such as streaming platforms and sources of unbiased information for cases concerning deeply authoritative states. Alright, so now that we know why the IP address is important, let's see how do I hide IP address I'm using from all the malicious people out there. The best way is to use a VPN, a virtual private network. They reroute your personal connection through their servers, which will change your IP address. The reason I prefer VPN to other ways to change IP address is that VPN also applies encryption, protecting your entire connection from third parties. Such parties include your internet service provider, various websites and advertisers, and in some cases, even hackers. But none of them could do anything when your connection is encrypted. For instance, one of the providers I use daily is NordVPN, and it utilizes virtually uncrackable AES 256 encryption to secure my connection. It even adds an option to apply a second layer of protection with double VPN servers, or a possibility to get a special dedicated IP just for me. Almost like a secret identity for online. And if you think I'm only answering the question of how to change IP address on Windows 10 or other computers, worry not. There are VPN apps for almost all devices nowadays that are out there, excluding maybe some really old smart TVs maybe. NordVPN also has servers all over the world to choose from, which fixes the issue with inaccessible content. While NordVPN protects your data from third parties, it doesn't collect it by itself. There's an audited no logs policy, RAM only servers, preventing any information from getting saved on the provider's servers. Naturally, there are more good options other than NordVPN. For instance, Surfshark has more country locations for streaming. And ExpressVPN includes a built-in password manager. If you'd like to explore your possibilities, check the description below for my links to the best VPN providers discounts included. But as I've mentioned before, VPNs are the most convenient, but not the only way to change IP addresses. Proxy servers have similar effects. Your IP address will change when passing through them, effectively hiding it. Proxies are also often faster than a VPN. But there is a catch. Using a proxy applies no encryption and adds no protection for your connection, so it can still be tracked. Your data can be accessed, and a lot of privacy and safety issues just aren't addressed. Plus, while VPNs cover all the connections coming from your device, including your browser and apps, and proxies often only work with a browser connection. But for every unsafe option, there's one I'd call overly secure, like the Tor browser. And just in case you're curious about what Tor stands for, it stands for the Onion Router because of the way it layers its connections. This browser uses a rather unique routing method. Instead of changing your IP address by connecting to a separate server, you'll connect through three different nodes in the Tor network. Each of these nodes is a volunteer, whether it's another user, a company, or other type of organization. By using their connection, you will hide your own. While Tor also applies encryption to your connection, there are multiple downsides. First, you can never choose what country connection you'd like to link to. Second, a lot of websites don't like Tor traffic and so just block it altogether. And third, due to long distance connections and encryption, you will end up dealing with very slow speeds. I'd only use that if you're worried about your safety enough to sacrifice your entire speed for it. One more method you might have thought of yourself is changing your network. Since your internet service provider is the source of your IP address, changing to a different Wi-Fi, mobile data, or so on will effectively change your IP address as well. Alternatively, you can restart your router for a dozen of minutes to get a new IP address as well. However, this method's kind of flawed since your new IP address will still be attached to your personal data and thus can still be tracked, leading to exposure of your private details. So, yeah, not every answer to how to change my IP address question is actually answering your concerns. So the three main takeaways from this video are, firstly, now you know what is IP address. It's an important online identifier that can be used to gather a lot of information about you. Second, hiding or changing your IP address is a responsible thing to do as it protects you from online threats and potentially giving access to content you wouldn't be able to access otherwise. And third, VPNs are the most reliable tool for changing IP address, and most alternatives are rather too slow, not secure enough, or just quite literally useless. So if you want to check out a VPN yourself, take a look in the description for links with my recommendations and with discounts applied. Otherwise, let me know if you prefer a different method or if you learned anything interesting in this video. Your responses are always a pleasure to go through. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.